Bağnazlar imanları zayıf oluyor. O kadar imana önem vermiyorlar.
Because it's people, they are emotional people. They have weakness in their faith. For instance, the fascists have all kinds of belief systems. The Hitler, for instance, they say that they come from Agartha. They just burn certain fire. They had this kind of primitive and childish understanding in their brains. Not to mention them like child, because children have beautiful understanding. But those people, those bigoted ones, they have romantic way of speaking. They are very emotional. They speak like music.
Deniz dalgaları oluyor. Adamın kafası denizin içinde olmuş oluyor böyle mesela.
They speak about the sea, that the waves are appearing over the sea. They have a special way of speaking. It's as if they don't believe in their own system. And this is not true faith, because true faith requires clarity. Because you are talking about the existence of Allah, it surely requires great total wisdom, because it is the most evident, it is the most important topic that one is talking about. But they have all kinds of doubtful, all kinds of suspicious way of looking at religion. They have weakness in their faith. And that is how their belief in the existence of Allah is. They are superficial people. They are standing against deep faith because they say that their faith should only be limited with a kind of a old people, old women like understanding. This means that they don't want thinking to be a part of their faith. They are diseased people. And the classical right-wing people, conservative people, they have their own styles. For instance, they wear a special jacket, for instance, and you can see the same jacket on every one of them. They have certain pants that look like one another, they smell like one another. They have bad qualities which again look like one another. They are not aesthetic people. They don't ever understand from aesthetics. They don't have art or quality in their lives. This needs to be turned into a book, really. This is not adequate to talk about this in a certain conversation. We need to describe this by saying that some part of the right wing has diseases. We can have this kind of a topic. I can have this like a book. I can have these in different parts, their way of wearing clothing, their way of foreign policy. They have only one mindset. They cannot have a secondary mindset because they are a kind of a fanatic into their way of thinking. For instance, they can maybe be against the Freemasons or the atheists, but you need to make efforts to make that person have faith. But they don't ever make any efforts to turn them to religion. They only talk badly against those people, just saying that they have had hatred, they have animosity against those people. They don't show the way to salvation, because if they want to lead them to salvation, they need to be equipped with knowledge themselves, because they don't have the faith that will be leading to a person to guidance, because they don't possess that wisdom themselves. They cannot speak in depth, because in terms of topics related with faith, actually, they don't do it. But we have a wide research capability. We can have a wide research, and we can look at their articles, look at their Facebook pages, and also their articles. Let us see how many times they have talked about the love of Allah, the love of people. That depth in religion is really very important, that they have given any instances about the facts of creation or the miracles of Quran. Or let us compare their statements with their speeches of hatred and animosity against people. And if we were to make a ratio, their hatred and animosity could be named as 100,000, and other beautiful topics that we have named do not exist at all, maybe a few times, 3 to 5 times, in an indirect way. It is very important to show this disease with this method, and there is no book related with this, which has been made beforehand, because it's a complex topic. It needs to be investigated in detail with great meticulous research. For instance, their way of clothing, they look like one another. They are not pleasant people. They cannot eat well. And they are not careful about their health also. They have these kinds of mutual way of action. They are hidden sinners, for instance, sinning activity. And they are insane people. And carrying out defamation and backbiting all the time. They are dirty people who have hatred of people. They express hatred very well. They cannot talk about love, mercy, and compassion. They don't have that talent to talk about this beauty. It's really very important because they cannot express their compassion, their mercy. If you were to ask that person to talk about these beautiful topics, beautiful manners, they wouldn't be able to do it. They cannot make any sentences. They cannot talk about those beauties. But if you were to call that people to hatred, you find them to be talking with great eagerness, and also they have no embarrassment. They have lost their faces. They are resistant and stubborn people. They are resistant and stubbornness in their hatreds. That is really very hard to dissolve. They don't ever see the goodness in a thing. For instance, let us find that there is a very beautiful atmosphere, a very beautiful setting, or very beautiful people. When those people come to those kinds of settings, they are negative people. They find a difficult, a negative part, a negative aspect in that community, in that group of beauty, and they just go against it. But there are different groups of people. Some of them are very severe. Some of them have different scales, some close to being goodness, some close to depths of evil.